You first, you need to digest the story. You need to understand the story. There's no way you want to tell the story you don't know. It's not possible. Even talking from a third person perspective, they say or they said, you need to digest the story. You need to. One of the things I try to do as a cinematographer before I jump on a film is I put myself in those shoes. How I want people to see the story. I want you to feel the story. And these are like things I consider before choosing the choices of my lenses. I want you to, if I want you to be in the moment, I know what to do. If I want you to be from another person's perspective, I mean, it is, yeah. So first you need to digest the story. Secondly, I think you also need to meet with your subject, because there's no way you just show up and then you feel it's just right for you to pop out the camera and start filming. You need to meet with your subjects and, you know, understand what they're feeling, how you want to tell the story of them. What is the best way to go about the story? Are you coming in from somebody else's perspective? Are you coming in from... So you just need to understand, get closer to the subject, know what they feel and interpret it to... So the third one would be create a short list. So after meeting with your subject, after understanding your story, create a short list. Decide within yourself how you want to go about the story. Yeah, so you create a short list that tells, that best tells the story. Yeah, if you want to, you know, like I said, from the third person's perspective or the second or immediate or anyhow, just know how you want to go about your story. So create a short list. And fourth one would be shoot a lot of B-rolls, because it's going to help your editor. Shoot a lot of abstracts, shoot a lot of B-rolls, and you'll be fine. The fifth is post it. And you always need to post your work. Always need to, you know, because it's an industry that has not yet been appreciated in Nigeria, so nobody really understands. Yeah, we only read stories, I mean, we read Twitter threads, and then how about to put it into film, into documentaries that people will understand, you know? And there's no how people will see if you don't post it. So yes, you might have done a lot of work, or you might have done a lot of back-end work. So at the end of the day, the way to be appreciated is to post your work. And people might not really like it, but if you keep doing it, I think they'll be forced to at the end of the day, if it's a good story. So yeah.